Hi and welcome to this week's Tech Talk. Today we're going to be talking about how the online three-phase UPS system distributes the input power being taken from the main supply equally across the three incoming phases, regardless of how the load connected to the output from the UPS system is balanced across the three outgoing phases. Now on the board here we have a very basic diagram of an online dual conversion UPS system. Now the online dual conversion UPS system operates simply by taking the AC voltage from the main supply, converting the AC voltage to DC voltage via the rectifier, which is referred to as the first conversion. We then reconvert that DC voltage back to AC voltage again via the inverter, which is referred to as the second conversion, and hence the term dual conversion. Now the term online simply means that the load is being constantly supplied via the inverter, and therefore, should there be a break or disturbance occurring on the incoming side of the UPS system, this is never seen by the connected load, because during these conditions, the inverter simply transfers from taking power from the rectifier to taking power from the connected batteries. Now this will occur seamlessly, and hence there is never any break or disturbance to the connected load, and hence the term online. Now one of the main benefits of the online dual conversion UPS system is the AC to DC, DC to AC conversion. Because we make this conversion, anything that is passing into the UPS system is never replicated on the output side of the UPS system, and therefore both the input and the output remain completely independent of one another, and this is referred to as VFI, voltage and frequency independent. Now, if we apply loadings onto this UPS system, and we consider that we're not providing any power to charge our batteries, and we have no losses through our UPS system, if we consider this UPS system to be, say, a 30 kilowatt UPS system, and we applied 10 kilowatts to each of the three outgoing phases, the 30 kilowatts in total on the output side of our UPS will be applied across to our DC bus, which in turn will be applied onto our three incoming phases via the rectifier. Now, under those conditions, we would get 30 kilowatts on the output, and we would apply 30 kilowatts to the input, again, assuming no losses. So therefore, we would have 10 kilowatts on phases 1, 2, and 3 on the output, and 10 kilowatts phases 1, 2, and 3 on the input. However, if we imbalance the loading on the outgoing side of our UPS system, say we apply 10 kilowatts onto phase 1, 5 kilowatts onto phase 2, and 0 kilowatts onto phase 3, then effectively we've only now got a maximum load of 15 kilowatts. Now the 15 kilowatts again will be passed through onto our DC bus within our UPS system, but this time the rectifier again will convert these across the three incoming phases, but this time we'll only apply 5 kilowatts to phase 1, 5 kilowatts across phase 2, and 5 kilowatts onto phase 3, effectively providing the 15 kilowatts required by the load, and hence our imbalanced load has now appeared balanced on our incoming supply to our UPS system. Now that is how the online dual conversion effectively balances the input regardless of how the outgoing side of the UPS system is imbalanced. Now obviously we must consider most online dual conversion UPS systems do have internal static bypass switches, and therefore if the UPS system is in bypass, then any imbalance on the outgoing side of the UPS system will be passed through directly onto our input supply, and therefore the infrastructure must be designed in order to support this. Well, I hope you found this Tech Talk useful. If you do have a question that you would like to us to answer, then please drop us an email to techtalk@riello-ups.co.uk. Thank you.